Hi, my name is Sunday. In this video, I'll be talking about the amount of code or ready to needed to apply for Italian citizenship. So there are many people who want to apply for Italian citizenship. So I'm not talking about ready to the cittadinanza or the citizenship income, which is that bonus. I'm not talking about that bonus. So I'm talking about people who want to become Italian citizen. So the amount of code needed already to the annual income. So many people, they don't know exactly the amount needed. Some have families, they have children and wife, so they don't know the exact amount needed to apply for it. So in this video, we're going through it one after the other, the amount of code already to needed before you can apply for it. And I swear, not just applying for it and stopping your work and throwing away everything. No. You still need to carry on with such code. And Azoe, what if you also give birth in the process of waiting for it? So I'll be telling you more about it. But first, I would like you to give this video a thumb up by clicking the like button. And for those ones that are watching me for the very first time, if you know you have not subscribed to my YouTube channel, please do subscribe and make sure you click the notification bell so whenever I upload any new videos or information, you will know. Now let's get started. First, in Galatians chapter 6 verse 9, the Bible says, "And let us not be weary in well doing, for in due season we shall reap if we faint not." So that is it. The Bible is admonishing and encouraging every one of us that we should not be tired in doing good. If you have done good to one person or the other, don't be tired in doing it. Don't because of you have done something good to one person, the person has turned everything to be bad to you because of that. You don't want to do good to any other person that come your way. Whoever that come your way, let's try in doing good to the person. Even if at the moment you have not received the reward, in due season, your reward must surely come. So that is it. So let's think about this. Let's keep that in mind. So now let's get into it. It says, what is the amount of ready to needed? So those people who really want to know, who want to apply for it, this is it. It says, one, 8,263 euros. So this is the amount of ready to needed per person. For one person, it says, for a single applicant, and it must be for the last 3 years before the application. So you need this amount in your code or in your ready to. Some people still don't know what we're talking about. The money you are working, if you are in autonomous, the money you declared. So at the end of the year, that's why they call it annual income. If you are receiving 1,000 euros every month, now times the 1,000 euro times 12, you have worked for 12 months. So it will now be almost 12,000 euros. So that's how it goes up. That's how you calculate your annual income. The money you receive every month times the months you work in that year. Then the amount will not be the total of it. So that's the annual income. So before you can apply for Italian citizenship, you need 3 years complete code. Not 17,000. If you want to apply, it's just a single person. They said it's going to be 8,263 euros in each of the code already. So the first one must be 8,263 above. Then the second one, the same thing. The third one, the same thing. If the first one is 6,000, the second one is 100,000, 500,000, it does not count. The three must be above this figure. So that is it. Get that in mind. If you are applying just a single person, if you are applying, this is the amount you need. Then two, 11,362.0 euro. So that is the amount for those ones who want to apply. For instance, you have wife already, or you have an husband, you are married already, you are living with somebody. The person says, for the single applicant with a spouse, so that is the amount you need to have. If for instance it's just you and your wife that you are living together, the moment there's no child yet, if you want to apply for Italian citizenship, even if you are the only one that is applying, does not mean that you and your wife must apply together. As far as your wife is living together with you, you need to have this figure, 11,362 plus. So that is it. Some people will say because it's just only them that want to apply. They have 3 children or 4 children. So the amount of the redditor is just, no, you can't do it. They need to calculate all other people that are under you. So that is how they do it. So if you are living together with your wife, even if you are just the only one to apply, or your wife is the only one to apply, you must get this 11,000 plus. So that is it. Then they said, and 516.46 euros for each dependent family member. If you have children, so 516 euros on each one. If, for instance, you, your wife, and a child, then first you need to have 8,200 just you alone, then plus your wife, altogether 11,365. Then whoever that is with you, one child, 516. So if it's 2 children, 516 times 2, that's how it goes up. So if you are having 2 children in your family, in your house, and you want to apply, just you alone, you want to apply for Italian citizenship, then you need to have 11,362 plus the 2 children, 500 plus. So everything will be roughly 12,000 plus. So that is it. You need to get that in mind. So this is the way they calculate it. For those ones who don't know about the figure or how they calculate it. And secondly, another thing is this. You must have these figures in all the 3 codes, because to apply for Italian citizenship, you need 3 years ready to, or 3 years school, 3 years annual income that you have worked before you need to apply. So that is, and the 3 of them must be above these figures. So you got to get that in mind. Not one very low, the other one high, the other one high. Even if the last one is even 100,000, if the first one is under the figure, you can't make use of it. So you got to get that in mind. Now, as well, for those ones that, for instance, after you have applied for Italian citizenship, maybe it was just you and your wife when you applied, then you were having just 11,000 plus and you're ready to. And now you have given birth. You have given birth. So what you need to do, you need to communicate with your prefettura that you have given birth. If not, that might stand as an hindrance for them granting you your citizenship. So you got to know that. If your redditor is not high, then quickly you need to find how you need to complete your redditor. If it's autonomous, go and look for autonomous or hard to read. If you know you have given birth to a child, maybe before your citizenship application will be finalized, it's maybe still in process, and you have given birth already. Maybe your last code that you use in applying was not even up to 12,000 because it was just you and your wife, and now you have given birth. You need to look for a redditor that we have to include that 500 euro plus, because per child is 500 euro plus. So that is what you need to do. And you need to communicate with your prefettura. If by God's grace you have the code or the redditor that is higher than the first one you use, maybe if you had your child to rate net, it will now be, let's say, 12,000 or 13,000. Quickly, you need to communicate with your prefettura. If not, that might stand as a delay to your citizenship being granted. So you got to know that in mind. And as well, to some people who, after they have applied, then maybe they'll just abandon and leave Italy, they will not be working any longer. According to the new law that is on ground, if you apply for citizenship, Italian citizenship, they still want you to continue doing or working in Italy, paying tax, and also meeting up with the redditor you use in applying. If you applied with, just let's say, just you and your wife, you applied with 11,000 plus, and now because of there's no job, your code or your redditor currently, maybe it takes 4 years or 3 years before the application, everything will be resolved. Maybe within the first or second year, your code now reduced to 9,000 or reduced to 8,000, 7,000, you have family. That might also stand as a barrier. They expect you to continue having that figure above that figure that you use in applying for it. You got to get that in mind. It was before that some people just applied, they will just abandon Italy, leave and go elsewhere. Before you know it, their citizenship will just come and they will call them to come and collect it. Now, what is happening? They are cross-checking, they are checking every time. They are still checking whether you are working or not. So you got to know that. Don't just abandon it. If you are traveling to elsewhere, at least you can put it in autonomous. Let your autonomous continue. Declare the code that is still above the one you use in applying. If not, it might stand as a barrier or as hindrance to what you are looking for. So you got to get that in mind. That is what has been hindering many people's own. That has been what has been making them to be staying long in coming out. And at the end, before you know it, they will tell you that you're ready to, currently it's too low because of you have not been working ever since, or your work has reduced. So you got to know that in mind. So these are the ready to needed, or the amount of code, annual income needed before you can apply for Italian citizenship. In other subsequent video, we're talking about the residence and all that things, what you need to put into consideration. Some people will just apply and just leave Italy, abandon their residence. That is another thing I'll also be talking about. Your residence must still continue reading and counting. And also those one before they apply, also talk about residence, how they need to take care of their residence so that they will not be holes in their residence. Because if they are holes in your residence, it might also stand as an hindrance to you applying for Italian citizenship. Thank you for watching. Thank you for listening. Please like, comment, and also share it to others as well. If you know you have not subscribed to my YouTube channel, please do subscribe. And make sure you click the notification bell so whenever I upload any new videos or information, you will know. Thank you and God bless you. Bye.